Tallulah and I have known each other in and around, and I know her parents, and you do too. Your parents are...
My mom and dad are brutes into me, which, you know, the fact that it's one name and you know who they are...
Says everything,
yeah.
So you wrote this Vogue article, and it came out in May, and it is the most beautifully written article. And it's also incredibly straightforward, incredibly brave, and incredibly transparent.
Thank you.
You talk about the struggles that you've gone through in your life. And I just want to open it up by saying, like, I really relate. Growing up in the public eye, in fact, may I put up two headlines that, you know, you and I both share? ET actress treated for alcohol abuse, and there you are, Demi Moore and Bruce Willis's daughter, Tallulah, checks into rehab. Like, these were things that I would have loved to keep to myself. Yeah. Did you feel that way? Like, you would have loved to have kept it to yourself?
I mean, I think anyone would. That's kind of the initial thought. When I was at the treatment center, a nurse actually leaked my information to the tabloids. And what was interesting is when they took me in the back office and said, you know, this is out, my first thought was, oh, I was waiting for this to happen. I didn't expect privacy to be present at 20 years old, doing something really scary. And because of the fact that it was kind of taken from me, the opportunity to share my story, or when I wanted to, when I came out into the real world again, it was really important for me to be even more transparent, because I felt like there was a real strength in sharing the vulnerability of that. And I felt like if somebody could feel less alone by me talking about this, and that's really why I wanted to do the Vogue article. Many years later, the headline that you posted was when I was 20. I'm almost 30. So it's been 10 years of moments that have continued to be taken from me. And when you're a public person, and I didn't choose to be a public person, I totally am aware of the myriad of beautiful things and tough things and all of the scope
so
of that.
So privileged, you don't feel like you can complain about it, but go on.
So, you know, I didn't have faith that there was a sacredness to my story, whether it be friends I told or people that I found out. And so I felt like the things that had occurred in the more recent years, I very visibly was struggling with an eating disorder. And because of the age of social media, and that was very present, and there was actually a tremendous amount of concern for me that I got on my Instagram. And as I'm early in recovery in that, so, you know, it's interesting to talk about it, because I don't know if I have, like, my full footing. I'm just trying every day. I wanted to talk about that because I felt like it was really important to share that it was really scary, that it was really hard.
Now, when you were younger, like, you know, the life, although it has so much privilege and blessing and great fortune, I've never felt like I could ever complain. I dare not. I'm too lucky. And it's interesting because you are someone who is really, I mean, when you read this article, the self-awareness you have, I don't want to complain. I know, nepo baby, I come from privilege. But there are things on the flip side of the coin. Hiding, you know, in a car because paparazzi are outside, running, you know, like, your parents are Bruce Willis and Demi Moore, one of the most famous, iconic couples on the planet. But there was also an awareness of, like, I call it paranoia. My dad coined the phrase, it's paranoia and Barrymore combined. And it's like, sometimes I have paranoia where I'm like, I think there's this guy in that tree. That's crazy. No, there is a guy in the tree. And you saw things about yourself at a very tender age. So how did you make peace with being criticized as a kid in the public to then going, I will be an adult who will engage with people in a healthy way? How do you do the boundaries? How do you make peace with it? How do you go to make a place a strength that was once a hurtful place?
I mean, I think that's a really powerful ask, and one that every day I'm still seeking to do better and do in a stronger way. Because, you know, when I think about the 13-year-old that took in strangers' opinion as fact.
Yes.
It was just fact. And now I have a choice a little bit more than I didn't have. And I also choose to see, like, you know, there'll be sometimes negative comments, like somebody, you know, commented on a photo of me and was going on and on about how much weight I gained and, you know, how bad I look. And this is, you know, after being very public about my struggles. And that still happens. You
and
know what
saying,
I mean?
I'm Tallulah, I'm overcoming an eating disorder, but somebody still feels the need to go in and say something negative.
Absolutely.
And that they know is going to cut deep, but it's...
Right, and I see that, and I take a beat, and I'm like, okay, I see the part in me that's the little girl that maybe is hurt from that. And then also, on the other side of it, like, I posted a photo recently in, like, a cute little, like, fall outfit, and somebody said, it's so wonderful to see someone that I think is so cool have a body like mine. And that meant so much to me. And I think that that's really special. I think that being able to relate to my sisters has been, you know, a really nice piece in this.